foretold how God's promise of love would unfold. A powerful vision of justice and freedom, this promise is for you.
Good morning. Welcome to the Family Liturgy of the Word on this first Sunday of Lent. We're the Kenyon family. This is
Colin,
Andrew,
Heather,
and I'm Mark. Please join us in song as we begin our liturgy.
Let us begin our prayer today in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Welcome to this Sunday's Liturgy of the Word. Today we celebrate the first Sunday of Lent. And if you remember from Ash Wednesday, Lent is a season where we celebrate 40 days when we are able to think about how Jesus calls us to live as his friends. And today from our Gospel, we follow Jesus into the desert. Friends, as we prepare ourselves to hear the word of God today, let us quiet our hearts to reflect on how we can continue to be open to Jesus' invitation to friendship and ask for God's mercy so that we may believe in the gospel. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And let us pray. O God, you give us every good gift. Help us to know that even as we face temptation, like Jesus in the desert, you never leave us. Strengthen us at the start of this Lenten season to persevere amidst difficulties. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God told Noah and his sons, "I am going to make a solemn promise to you and to all who live after you. This includes the birds and animals that came out of the boat. I promise every living creature on earth that the earth and those living on it will never again be destroyed by a flood. The rainbow that I have put in the sky will be my sign to you and to every living creature on earth. I will tell you that I will keep this solemn promise forever. When I send clouds to cover the earth and the rainbow appears in the sky, I will remember my promise. To you and to all other living creatures, never again will I let floodwaters destroy all life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Teach us of your ways, O Lord, and guide us in your truth. Lord, make known your ways to me. Make me walk in your truth. And teach me, Lord, for you are God, my Savior. Teach us of your ways, O Lord, and guide us in your truth. Lord, remember your mercy and the love you shown from of old. In your love, remember me. Teach us of your ways, O Lord, and guide us in your truth. The Lord is good and upright. He shows the path to those who stray. He guides the humble in right pathways. Teach us of your ways, O Lord, and guide us in your truth.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Think about what it's like to have somebody break a promise to you, or to break a promise yourself. It's never a good feeling, right? We can feel hurt if someone breaks a promise to us, and usually we feel guilty if we break a promise to somebody else. One of my earliest childhood memories, I must have been like 5 years old, is a broken promise. I remember being on a playground on a hot summer's day, and we were playing with water balloons. Now, if you know anything about water balloons, you know that they're really precious because they take forever to make, and they break so easily, and also because you can torture your friends and your siblings with them, so they're just great. And I had this perfect water balloon as a little boy, and I was gonna throw this water balloon at my sister. And then this older boy came up to me and he said, "Hey, can I borrow that water balloon? I'll give it right back, I promise." Well, I didn't know any better, so I said, "Sure, here you go." And then I just stood around waiting for him to bring me back the water balloon Obviously, he threw it at somebody, and I never got the water balloon back. And so I was very confused. I was upset. And so that's one of my earliest childhood memories. But, you know, I also have memories of breaking promises to other people. I've done that, too. And you know what's strange about that is when somebody points that out to me, I feel just as bad about that as having a promise broke to me. Even when I'm the promise breaker, I have a similar bad feeling. It's a feeling like part of me has been taken away, or that I'm not whole anymore, or that I'm not myself, or that I'm incomplete somehow. Well, the season of Lent is a time to focus on what makes us complete, especially when we don't live up to our promises. Love makes us complete, especially God's love. This is why we often give up things for Lent, or why we generously give to others. It's because we know that those things, they don't really make us complete or whole. And so we give them up, or we're generous with them to make room for love and to make more love in our lives, because that makes us complete. The first reading and the psalm today are all about God's covenant with us. A covenant, in the general sense of the word, it's kind of like a promise or a contract. But contracts and promises that we use kind of every day in this world, they can get really complicated. For you parents out there, think about signing your mortgage agreement. I'm not a homeowner myself, but I've heard from other homeowners that nobody ever really knows what they're signing when they sign those things. Or you might think also about signing up for a service, like an app or some service online, where you have to scroll down all this text and then click "I agree" at the end of it. Nobody actually reads that. Nobody really knows what we're agreeing to. These things are really complicated. But a holy covenant, like the one that God made with us, is different. A holy covenant is actually quite simple. A holy covenant sounds like this. I'm yours, and you're mine. That's God's holy covenant with us. I'm yours, and you're mine. I will be your God, and you will be my people. After the flood, when Noah built the ark, and the flood subsided, God promised to be faithful to us and to hold up his end of the promise forever. And God has renewed that promise over the ages. And God made that promise permanent for us by sending Jesus, our new covenant. When Jesus was resurrected, we received the greatest proof of God's faithfulness to his promises, that God is with us, even beyond death. That's the holy covenant with God. I'm yours, and you're mine. I will be your God, and you will be my people. If you feel let down by other people not delivering on their promise, or if you feel like a piece of you is missing or is damaged because you haven't kept up your promises, Lent is a good time to let God's promise of eternal love make up for that, and to make us feel complete and whole again. Because God's promise cannot fail. God gave Noah and his family a rainbow to symbolize this special kind of covenant. I think a rainbow is a great symbol for a holy covenant. God is promising that God will always make something beautiful out of things that might seem scary and dark, like thunderstorms, for example. There's often a rainbow afterward. God gives us an abundance of color, light, different colors blending and separating in harmony with each other. If I had to pick my own symbol for a covenant, and for God's covenant, I would pick a running river. It will always fill us up, for example. And it always would help us with our thirst, just like God's love does. And it would give you plenty of water to make water balloons or squirt guns for pestering your siblings. Reflection question. Pick one symbol or image that reminds you of God's faithfulness. How can you pray with that symbol or image this Lent?
We bring our prayers and requests before our God.
That this Lenten season may be a time to renew our faith and grow in spirit with our entire parish community, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders and members of our church may promote the gospel in a way that welcomes all peoples, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as we continue Black History Month, we may come to appreciate the need for repentance and reparation, and for an end to all forms of racism, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all peoples of the world may become better stewards of creation and spread peace, justice, and reconciliation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That rainbows may remind us of how special our world, nation, and church are because of our diversity, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the dying, those who mourn, and all those in need of our prayers, may they come to know the healing and saving power of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they come into the fullness of God's kingdom, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of the desert, help us to live through times of difficulty, temptation, and testing, so that we might grow strong in proclaiming and living the gospel truths of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's pray in song and gestures the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Thank you so much for participating in today's Family Liturgy of the Word. Lift up your voices and sing. If you and your family are interested in making music for our liturgies, please contact me, Andrea, for more information. Still not sure what to do for Lent this year? Check out some of our resources that could be helpful to you and your family during this time. See our most recent flock note for more. Many thanks to all who offered their time and talents this week, including our host family, the Kenyans, Mickey Zabello, and all of our wonderful families offering their gift of music, to Deacon Mike for sharing the Word of God and giving us a beautiful homily, and to Molly Manning and Michael Sennett for piecing together this week's liturgy. And let us pray. O Lord, thank you for the gift of your word. Having received this gift, we ask for the grace to be more like Jesus in our words and deeds. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May God bless us, protect us from evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Tree of life and awesome mystery, in your death we are reborn. Though you die in all of history, still you rise with every morn. Still you rise with every. Of life beyond conceiving, mighty Spirit of our Lord, give us strength to our believing, give us faith to live your word, give us faith to live your word. Tree of life and awesome mystery, in your death we are reborn. Though you die in all of history, still you rise with every morn. Still you rise with every
justice and freedom, this promise is filled.